Celtics season come to an end. In that moment, we caught a glimpse of what it means to be Larry Bird, what it means to be a champion. Will we see it again today? This is the NBA on NBC. Today, it's the Boston Celtics versus the Cleveland Cavaliers.
A beautiful spring day in suburban Cleveland at the Richfield Coliseum site of today's Game 7. Boston arriving here less than 2 hours ago with the tradition of 16 NBA championships behind them. And the young and hungry Cavaliers. Brad Doherty entering the arena for the biggest game of his pro life. Indeed, the biggest game for this entire Cleveland franchise. And inside the Coliseum, a raucous crowd, standing room only, over 20,000 here for today's deciding game. And the Cavs are tough at home. Their only 92 home playoff loss, game two to Boston, and they have taken 20 of their last 22 games at the Coliseum. But the Celtics have a wealth of seventh game experience. While the Cleveland franchise has only one seventh game 16 years ago, the Celtics have played in 20 and are 6-1 in the Larry Bird era. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Richfield Coliseum. Tom Hammond with former Phoenix Suns coach, Tom Fitzsimmons. He just retired after the Trailblazers knocked him out of the playoffs. Your misfortune is our gain. Glad to have you here. We did see that Cleveland has the home court advantage. Boston has the edge in seventh-game experience. Which is more important?
Well, for the Cleveland team, they need this crowd here today. They need this home court. The Celtics don't need anything. They've been here before.
In Game 6, Boston stayed alive by handing the Cavaliers their worst playoff loss in history, and they did it behind Larry Bird, ailing back and all. He had 16 points and 14 assists. Can he duplicate that kind of effort here today?
Well, don't bet against Larry Bird, but I think you'll see the Cavaliers a different look today. I think you'll see Mike Sanders picking him up all over the court. I thought he'd pick him up on the team bus when they got in, but he didn't do that. I think they're going to try to make Larry Bird beat him off the dribble today rather than standing still and passing.
Well, the Cavaliers also have to be concerned with the offensive star of this series so far, and that's been Reggie Lewis, averaging over 28 points a game for the Celtics. How will they try to stop him today?
Well, I think Chris Moore's going to isolate him a lot, so Lenny Wilkins will probably let Reggie Lewis get started on his own. But if he gets too hot and gets crazy like he did in a couple of those games, expect to see Mark Price come over and double, leave back the open.
All right, that sets the stage for what has been a dead even series in every respect. First of two great games on NBC today. And for a preview of what's yet to come, let's go to New York and check in with Bob Costas. Robert?
Okay, Tom. Thanks a lot. Hi, everybody. Following the Celtics and Cavaliers, as Tom said, we'll have Game 7 of the Knicks and the Bulls from Chicago Stadium. And at halftime of that one, we'll bring you exclusive live coverage of the NBA draft lottery, which still keeps Shaquille O'Neal as the major prize. The very first lottery took place in 1985 when the New York Knicks got the first pick and turned it into Patrick Ewing. Ewing is a big part of the story today in Chicago, of course. More on his sprained left ankle, we go to Chicago and bring in Marv Albert and the well-traveled Magic Johnson. Marv?
Have to be very effective. What you've got to watch for in this game is the middle. If Michael Jordan is able to penetrate the middle, then you know that the Bulls are getting done what they want done from. Because once they do that, he can start kicking it out. So the most important thing is watch how the middle is protected. If Patrick is not effective, Michael can get in there and make some things happen.
Okay, coming up, the first of today's Game 7 showdowns. It's the Celtics and the Cavaliers. In just a few minutes, Tom Hammond and Fitzsimmons will rejoin you right after these commercial messages, and we'll see you at halftime. Welcome back to the Coliseum in Richfield, Ohio, before the seventh and deciding game in the Eastern Conference semifinals. John Bagley and Reggie Lewis in the backcourt for the Celtics. Lewis averaging 28 points a game. Bagley at the point. The forwards, Larry Bird, starting for the second consecutive game. Kevin Gamble on the other wing. And 38-year-old Robert Parrish, the center, is headed up and down. Short for the Cavs. Mark Price at the point. And Craig Elo, who has the defensive assignment on the high-scoring Lewis. At the forward for Cleveland, Larry Nance, capable of a big game. He had 32 in an earlier game. Mike Sanders, field defense, Larry Bird. And Brad Doherty, leading scorer and rebounder for the Cavaliers, 23 points, 10 boards a game. The offense flows through him. Lenny Wilkins is 2-1 in seventh games when he was coach of the Seattle Supersonics. So Don Criqui is with us and had a chance to visit with both teams before the game. Don, what do you find out?
As you know, the Cavs are the favorite for the seventh and confidence. Kevin McHale has been emphasizing it's not where you play, but how you play. And we've won here three times, says he. The Celtics also took note of a big side outside on the way over the red. This way to Larry Bird's last game. The Celtics don't think so. A number of Cleveland fans camped out overnight to get the last tickets. When the Cavs won that seventh game here back in 76, they came out of the stands and tore down the basket. Feel the team that takes command of the first quarter is going to win game seven. Here's Tom.
All right, Don, in that crucial first quarter just about to get underway, do you agree with that assessment? Tom, the first quarter very important to the outcome?
I think it's extremely important to the Cavaliers. I don't think it'll bother the Celtics unless they fall way behind because of their experience.